Good afternoon and welcome back to Adventure Planet, where today I've come back here for my annual visit to Brean Theme Park, located here in Somerset on the west coast of the United Kingdom. Now, Brean Theme Park actually sits within Brean Leisure Resort, which typically has, you know, your restaurants and show venues. There's a water park here, a soft play area, and plenty of camping and caravanning options if you did want to come down for maybe a weekend or more. In terms of the theme park itself though, yeah, it's quite small in terms of area, but there is over 40 rides and attractions here for all ages, including four roller coasters, including that beast behind me, the newly relocated Crazy Loop, which is now called Bulldog Coaster. We'll be getting on that a little bit later on. Now, in terms of entry, there's an assortment of wristbands that are actually supplied here at Brean, or you can just come in and pay as you go using what they call a fun card. Now, that can be picked up at any of the pay booths here, and you load those up with credits. Each credit costs £1, and the rides here cost between 2 and 6 credits. It's worth noting, though, that if you do pay to ride, you do need to fill up that card with at least 5 credits to gain entry to the park. This park's no longer a free to enter park, as it were. Park hours today, 11 a.m. right the way through until 9 p.m. and we've got some fireworks to check out a little bit later on as well. So let's head on in to Brean Theme Park. And here we are inside the park itself, and through one of 3 entrances here at Brean. I've decided to start on the leftmost side of the park and basically work my way all the way over to the right. Yeah, we've got the Wave Swinger right in front of us here, and this is new since I came last year. The old Pony Express. I think it's been there for some time, but I've not been to Brean since June 2022. Of course, if you want to check out that vlog, that is on the Brean playlist right here on the channel. Hey, yeah, I like this. Some good theming there. All themed around cowboys. Old Wild West. Yeah, look at the old cactus there and the barrels. Yeah, that looks great. Yeah, of course, we've also got the Adventure Golf here as well. And we've also got the go-karts. Now, worth noting that the go-karts are not included in your wristband, even if you opt to get the mega wristband, which includes all rides. Go-karts are not included. If you are paying per ride when you come here, these will cost you 6 credits. So yeah, this is one of the more expensive ones. But yeah, it's not a bad track. Not huge. Yeah, just a little bit of a chicane through here and then back round and around. And yeah, we got the Wave Swinger here as well. Hey, it looks really nice. Great weather for it as well. Yeah, really nice. And in terms of wristbands then, I've got this one here, my mega wristband, which I paid just £16 for. If you purchase online, you can get a 10% discount. And that wristband for £16 is just for today. Basically means you can't enter the park until 2 p.m. However, it's right the way through until 9 and includes those fireworks. Hey! They also do a junior wristband, which is for rides between 1 meter and 1.2 meters. And also a tots wristband, which is anything under 1 meter. Worth noting that if you do actually come to Brean Theme Park and purchase your tickets here at the park, you can get a tots wristband for free, which is well worth considering. Great Wave Swinger. It really is a fantastic looking Wave Swinger, that. And that goes for the rest of the park really here at Brean. Although it is quite a small park, it is always really well maintained. All this flooring here always looks really good. All the rides look really fresh and colorful. Hey, you got a little junior drop tower there. Hey, little games and prizes just off to the left. And what you might notice, which is different compared to last year's vlog, is the removal of a couple of rides here, actually, one of which is the big wheel that used to actually sit just here. Yeah, that was packed up not too long ago and left the park. And yeah, they've kind of replaced it with this child's kind of play area here with all these blow-up slides and, yeah, some of these kind of slide downs here. And they've actually got the big wheel, a blow-up version this time, which, yeah, still looks pretty cool. And there's a little bit of a seating area just out the front for the adults to sit down and chill out a little bit. And that's just to the right of the go-karts here. And just if you want to know if there's any official ride closures throughout the park here at Brean, you can find that out on their website. The only official closure today is X Factory here. Yeah, this is a Miami type ride, and yeah, it's not looking in the best condition at the moment. The entire carriage has been completely removed here. Yeah, one of the struts are empty there, showing all the workings inside. Yeah, it's looking pretty sorry for itself at the moment. Yeah, that can be found right opposite the Skydiver attraction here. It's a little, like I say, junior drop tower. A bit of a bounce tower, really. We hopped on this last year, and it was pretty good. I'll give it another go. Let's get on. And I've just had rides on both the Wave Swinger and Skydiver here at Brean. And yeah, both offer some really good views over the park, especially the Wave Swinger actually, with views over obviously the go-karts, the golf course, and that new Pony Express ride that's gone in. Now, for those that may have watched the vlog from Brean last year, you may have realized that, you know, there was some kind of uncertainty over whether or not we were actually allowed to film on ride here. Now, some operators were letting us, some weren't. However, in the time since that last vlog, they have come out, updated their terms and conditions, and basically no on-ride filming is allowed here anymore, which is a bit of a shame. It's a bit of a draconian law in my view. It's something that if you've got a securely mounted GoPro on either a chest mount or a wrist strap, that it really should be allowed. However, they have updated their T's and C's. That is no longer the case. I did contact the park 4 days before coming here just to see if they would make an exception for obviously a YouTube vlog. Unfortunately, no response as per Oakwood, which is a little bit disappointing. What they really need here is something along the lines of Energylandia at most parks here in the UK, where you get your mount and your GoPro tested by security, and then you get a sticker to say that you can now use that to film on rides. I feel like that is really what the UK kind of needs to look at. So unfortunately, no on-ride filming today. However, if you check out last year's vlog, we did get quite a few on-ride POVs of some of the coasters here, like Magic Mouse and Astro Storm, and some of the flats as well, like Wipeout, the Wave Swinger, and others. And a little bit of off-ride footage there then of Ultimate. Little Matterhorn ride themed to the Avengers. Yeah, not a bad little ride, that one. A little bit on the slow and rickety side, and it doesn't go backwards. However, it's still a pretty good ride here at Brean. Now we got some footage of the Dodgems here. One way around, no bumping. Yeah, that rule's gone out the window. And as mentioned at the intro then, Brean Theme Park is home to over 40 rides and attractions for all ages. Some for the younger ones here. We got these crazy boats, little bumper boats really, that can spray out water out the front. Out of these little things here, use the button on the handles to squirt people with water. Yeah, it looks really fun. And we got the little remote boats over here as well. All looks nice and clean. Yeah, they do a great job, like I say, of maintaining this park. It always looks really, really fresh, really well cared for, no litter anywhere. Yeah, really, really nice. And they got a little roundabout ride here as well. Coin-operated water guns. Oh, there you are. Yeah, nice little roundabout ride for the kids there. And then just past that, we've got Fantasia. It's also worth noting it's a dog-friendly park as well. Plenty of water around for the dogs if you do want to bring your pets. Yeah, there you go, Fantasia. Yeah, nice little ride this. All really well themed, all those vehicles around. Just basically circles around up the top here. And then back to the start. Yeah, all really well themed across the top, all the Disney characters up there. Yeah, really nice. And welcome to one of the most intense KMG afterburners in the country, if not the most intense. It's Wipeout here at Brean. Actually voted the scariest ride in the park a few years ago on an episode of Brainiac Science Abuse. And it is an intense one, this. Absolutely fantastic ride. Opened here in 2002. Yeah, pretty sizable queue for that one as well. Yeah, a lot of people waiting to go on there. Just had a brief rain shower. Looks like that's just passed over though. Blue skies again coming out, which is nice. And we got a twister here as well. Nice little scrambler ride. This one's also pretty intense as well. Honestly, the number of flat rides they've got here at Brean really is good. And there's some intense ones in the mix. Yeah, like I say, including Twister and the KMG Afterburner Wipeout. We've also got Wild Water here as well, which is a little two-drop log flume. Opened in 2001, manufactured by Revachon. And we got another little flat ride for the kids here. This is the farm train. Look how colourful this is. Yeah, love all the bits of theming around here as well. You got the cows, little hedgehog, the old cabin there. Yeah, it looks really nice. And not forgetting the big monkey here as well. Yeah, look at that. Yeah, really nice themed ride that. And right next to that, we've got a little junior boat ride. All these little log flumes here. Again, more theming around with the Indian and his pet dog. Yeah, I love all this. Yeah, really nice bits of theming throughout. And of course, that noisy techno jump in the background, which is Disco Fever. Yeah, really nice. And yeah, we got the little coin-operated rides here as well. No one was riding those last year either. They get a little bit neglected. I feel like this space could be better utilized, to be honest, with another flat ride, perhaps. Yeah, like again, all kind of the hoardings around here looks all nice. Wild Water in the background there. And of course, you got the trampolines just behind this cage here. That was obviously here last year. However, what isn't anymore, another ride removal here at Brean, is the booster. Yeah, we used to have the tallest ride in the park, just situated about here. It wasn't actually in operation last year, but now it has been completely removed, and they've kind of replaced it with a little bit of a seating area here, which is nice, just if you want a little bit of a chill out. And just watch some of the rides opposite here, which of course includes that techno jump, Disco Fever, and some of the little kid rides just around here, like that log flume. And right next to that seating area, we of course have the Caterpillar Coaster. And as they say, a cred is indeed a cred, so we'll be jumping on here. Have all the little flowers up here and stuff. Yeah, really, really nice. We'll hop on. Hey! Hey! And here he comes, the Caterpillar Coaster. Yeah, a little Wacky Worm coaster for the family. It was actually a new ride last year, opened in 2022, manufactured by DPV Rides. Yeah, fun little coaster, this one. And worth picking up the cred if you've not already. Two-lap special. And I've just had my ride then on the Caterpillar Coaster, new for last year, manufactured by DPV Rides. And oh yeah, it's a quick one that trims too much as well, trims way too much. Anyway, I'm down kind of the right side of Brean Theme Park now, and this is where you'll find all of the coasters that can be found here, including the Caterpillar Coaster. You've also got Magic Mouse, you've got the new Bulldog Coaster, and of course Astro Storm. You've also got one of the more intense flat rides here as well, which is Orbiter, which is a Tivoli Extreme. Let's go and check it out. And we've also got a Zamperla Disco here as well, just one of the smaller ones. Opened back in 2015. Hey, there he is. He's still here. Hey, how you doing, fella? Oh, you got some cobwebs on you. Yeah, a little bit of theming around. Yeah, good disco, this one as well. Like I say, one of the smaller ones, but yeah, still packs a little bit of a punch. And then, yeah, look at this now down this end of the park. It looks absolutely fantastic. You've obviously got the Magic Mouse there, all nicely painted up. The pink track and the green supports. You've got the new ride for 2023, the pirate ship there. Another little flat ride for the kids just here, a little roundabout ride. And to the left, we have, of course, Orbiter, as we spoke about earlier. But look at Bulldog. Look how fantastic that looks. That red track, the blue supports against that blue sky. It really does look the part down here. Pirate looks great as well. Look at that. It's a half of the park now down here at Brean that really does look so fresh. It looks fantastic. And then, of course, we have Astro Storm to the left as well, which used to be a Blackpool Pleasure Beach, as Space Invader 2. Great coaster, that is. Great enclosed coaster, manufactured by Zera. Comeback came in and done some refurbishments in between when it used to be a Blackpool Pleasure Beach and then the reopening here at Brean. But it's a great enclosed coaster, that. Something that we need more of here in the UK. And then the Tivoli Extreme Orbiter. Not quite as intense as Spin Jam, this one, but it still packs a punch. Let's get on. And I've just got off my ride on Orbiter then, the Tivoli Extreme here at Brean. And yeah, along with Wipeout, those are the two most intense flat rides that you'll find here at the park. Anyway, it's time to ride. You just hear it behind me, the Bulldog Coaster, Brean's newest coaster. Technically, it's not new, it's been here before as Crazy Loop. However, it has spent a significant period of downtime while it was relocated and refurbished. And I gotta say, I'm loving the British theme on here with the Bulldog and the blue supports, the red track. It looks absolutely fantastic. Little Pinfari coaster this, originally manufactured back in 1981. And it's seen life at Pleasure Island, Flamingoland, as well as here at Brean Leisure Park as Crazy Loop. As a matter of fact, it does still say Crazy Loop on the train, so a little bit of a shame that they've not actually updated the signage on the trains. Unfortunately with this, however, it is a very slow throughput. It's only running the one train and it's only 8 riders per train, so the queue for this is pretty significant at the moment. However, we'll jump on, see how it rides. and just had my ride on the Bulldog Coaster then, manufactured back in 1981 by Pinfari. And you know what? Yes, they haven't changed the trains on there. The old branding is still in place, in fact, as I said earlier. But you know what? That is a solid ride here. The best coaster at Brean, I would say, just above Astro Storm, which is behind me here. Really quite smooth, even though it is running those old trains, and that loop is nice and intense. They definitely need a second train on there though, really slow throughput, queued for almost an hour. The ride itself, about a minute and a half long, great ride, looks the part here at Brean. Yeah, I'm gonna get on for a second go, and then I'm gonna go and head down to one of the restaurants here and grab myself some lunch. And for some food at Brean then, I've opted for a sausage roll and a cappuccino. This was £6.20, £3 for the sausage roll and £3.20 for the cappuccino. Yeah, I'm gonna finish this up and then head back over to Astro Storm. And this is the park spinning coaster then. This is Magic Mouse. Yeah, nice colorful coaster, this one. Love the pink track with the green supports. Actually looks quite nice against obviously the red track and blue supports of the Bulldog coaster. Nice bit of interaction just up here as well between the two. And yeah, for those that have watched a lot of the vlogs on this channel, you'll know that I do like a good Revision spinner. Yeah, good coasters these. Standard layout for this one, opened back in 2007. I've just had my ride on Magic Mouse then, the 2007 Revachon spinning coaster here at Brean, and unfortunately I didn't get much of a spin at all on my ride. I was there with three other people and yeah, didn't really get much spin at all. On Revachon, that's actually quite surprising. Usually the SBF Visa versions of these rides, you don't get much of a spin because they tend to be quite slow. However, yeah, first time I've not had much on a Revachon equivalent. Great ride though, great views over the park, and now with Bulldog Coaster in place, like I say, the interaction between those two is pretty great at the top there. And you also have Terror Castle here at Brean, which in my opinion is one of the best ghost trains in the country. This facade is absolutely fantastic. It really does look great still. It's a great experience this. Unfortunately, like I say, can't film on ride. However, this was one of the rides that we did film in the vlog last year. So if you do want to see an on-ride POV of Terror Castle, take a look at last year's vlog. Yeah, this opened in 2000. And like I say, it is a great experience this. But again, low throughput. Queue is looking pretty long here. Probably a good 45 minutes. But a great ride nonetheless. And it's worth noting that it's not just about the rides here at Brean Theme Park. Just on the outskirts of the park, you have all of these stalls here, which unfortunately are all just closing up shop for the day. It is about 6:30 now, so it is kind of getting a little bit later in the day. But there's the Magic Mouse here, just for location terms. All of these stalls here were all open earlier, selling various gifts. You've got crystal stalls here, lots of little cafes and eateries. You've got food pavilions here as well. All this kind of stuff is all now closed up. You've got the licensed bar just over the back there as well, and lots of other kind of little stalls all dotted around that you can have a look whilst you're here at the park. And yeah, like I say, this is all starting to close up now, which is a little bit unfortunate. I should have filmed this earlier on today. Missed it last year as well, which is a little bit of a shame. But yeah, this is all just on the outskirts of the park. Like I say, there's three different entrances into Brean Theme Park, and these kind of little stalls we'll kind of connect those three entrances up, if you like. Hey! The old train. The old Brean Leisure Park. The old train service there. Yeah, that's cool. Just past the little market stalls that we were at just a moment ago. This is obviously where you'll find the Brean Splash Water Park here and the Brean Soft Play area as well. That is just opposite the Food Court Pavilion, which can be found just through here. Yeah, and it's a good water park that. If you ever get the chance to do it, go in there, lots of water slides. And then just a little bit further past that, you have the Brean Soft Play area, which, yeah, again, is all kind of for the little young kids. If you want to leave them there, well, you go and enjoy yourself in the park. Not that I would do that, of course. You've also got the Tavern Beer Garden just over there, and they have a whole host of entertainment going on, usually live singers and stuff in there, as there was this morning. Yeah, if you just want to sit there, chill with an alcoholic drink, certainly in the nice weather like it has been today, yeah, it's actually a nice place to sit. All dog friendly as well, there's a coffee shop in there. And then just to the left we got burgers and chips, serving great British meat. Oh, there we are. I should probably have got one of those instead of the hot dog I had earlier. I didn't have a hot dog, I had a sausage roll. Yeah, you got cash withdrawals just to the right there as well if you do need some cash. And of course we have another entrance into the theme park just through here, and plenty more outdoor seating as well. Got sweet treats here. There's also an ice cream parlor back down that way, which again is currently closed up, a little bit late in the day for that. There's also an 18-hole golf course here as well, which is just kind of behind those trees there. Actually quite an impressive golf course really. And then you have the kind of miniature version of the Congo Adventure Golf, which is just here. Yeah, you got a little flat ride here. Looks like that's out of action though. Looks like it might have been for a long time. I think this was out of action last year as well. Yeah, and like I said, in terms of entry, I paid £16 for my wristband today, which is a specialized price because of the fireworks. Usually the mega wristband, which I've got here, is £28.80 online with your 10% discount. Parking here is also not free. You do have to park in a pay and display, but it's only £4.50 for the entire day, so not too bad. And after that sausage roll then, and a little bit of a tour on the outskirts of Brean Theme Park, it's time to head back over to Astrostorm. Like I say, this actually came from Blackpool Pleasure Beach, used to be Space Invader 2, then Kumbak came in, done some refurb, and then it reopened here at Brean, and it's a great coaster, this great enclosed coaster. But I just thought I'd show you a little bit around kind of the outskirts of the theme park, just so that there's kind of, so that you know there's more to see than just obviously the rides here themselves. Yeah, lots of market stalls. Like I say, you've got that water park here as well, and plenty of caravanning options if you do want to stay here for a weekend or more. So yeah, well worth checking that out. But anyway, I'm nice and full now from that hot dog, sausage roll, I keep calling it a hot dog, and the coffee. We're going to head over to Astrostorm now and check out this absolutely awesome Zero enclosed coaster. And here's a closer look at that new for 2023 ride, the pirate ship. Yeah, it looks great. Nice and fresh, as you'd expect for a brand new ride. Love the theming on this one as well. Yeah, I love this. It looks great. And just got off my ride on Astrostorm then, and you know what, I know what I said earlier, but actually I think between that and Bulldog it's actually pretty close. Absolutely love Astrostorm, riding really really well, nice and smooth, great little four-man bob from Zero with some great effects in there, all of them working as well. You've got that air cannon right at the top of that first lift hill, and then quite a speedy coaster through that enclosed environment, which like I say, we just don't have enough of those here in the UK. It's the closest that we can get to something found in a Disney park, kind of like Space Mountain, I guess. Very, very close to that, and it is a great ride. Great audio effects in there as well. Great lighting, great bits of theming. It really is a quality ride. Anyway, the sun is starting to dip down now. I'm going to put a few more bits of footage around the park as we approach dusk. Then we'll be settling in for those fireworks a little bit later on. Thank you. just had another ride on Terror Castle then, and yeah, as I showed you earlier, the facade to the ride is absolutely fantastic, but also on the side of the show building here, look at all this theming, it looks great. I'm not sure if this has kind of been redone or just given a good cleanup, but it looks a lot better than it did when I came here just over a year ago. Yeah, love all this. That looks absolutely fantastic. Look at that. Great piece of artwork on the side of the show building here. Some more footage around the park then. We've got 5 minutes until the fireworks start here. Yeah, it should look great with the Bulldog Coaster in the foreground. Great lighting packages on both Orbiter and the new pirate ship here. Magic Mouse in the background, yeah, all looking fantastic. Highlights of the fireworks coming up.
Yeah.
with that fireworks show then, I am now back in the car after having had a fantastic day at Brean. Yeah, unfortunately, as I was about to film the close down of the vlog, all the lights kind of started to go out, so had no light in the park, had to come back to the car. Yeah, it's been an absolutely fantastic day, and that was a great fireworks show as well. Some really loud and impressive fireworks there, certainly in the sort of last 30 seconds or so of the show. I felt like maybe they could have turned off the lights on the Bulldog Coaster. That kind of took away a little bit from it, a little bit of light pollution coming off of there. But otherwise, it was a great fireworks show, all with Katy Perry's fireworks playing in the background. And you know what? It's been a great day overall. I always like getting down to Brean. And you know what? Today, it was great to see it really busy. Brean was one of those parks that was quite hard hit post-pandemic, as most parks were, but Brean more so. So to see it really thriving today was great. The only negative of that was the operations for their two main coasters, really, Astro Storm and the Bulldog Coaster. Yeah, queued for around an hour for both of those. Both of them just running the one train, really quite slow operations on there. So that'd be nice to see that kind of fixed for the future. The rest of the park, absolutely fantastic. Yeah, it was great to get back on Wipeout again, Terra Castle, and some of the great flats here like Orbiter as well, and of course the four coasters that they have here as well. It's been a really great atmosphere. And you know, the Bulldog Coaster, yes, it's not exactly new, it's just a relocation and a retheme, but it really does look fantastic with that British color scheme, you know, and the bulldog kind of on the front of with all the theming. It does look great, and it's actually helped to expand the park as well, because before that was relocated to where it is, the boundaries of the park, if you like, actually stopped at the end of Astro Storm's building. So that's actually pushed the park out that little bit further as well, which has freed up some more space around the park for future investments that may come from Brean. And I hope they do. Like I say, it's great to see the park busy, and new flat rise or a new family coaster as well at some point will only you know, help to pull more of those crowds in. So yeah, overall, it's been a fantastic day. And like I say, it's not just the theme park here. There's lots to do just on the outskirts as well, and it is a resort owned by Unity, so if you do want to come down, spend a weekend here or longer, as I've said in the vlog earlier, you know, there's plenty to see and do here, as well as actually traveling around Brean itself. It's a really, really nice place to see just on the coast here. Brean Sands, really, really nice to go and visit as well. Anyway, that's been it from Brean Theme Park. Hope you've enjoyed the vlog. Yeah, the next video will be coming up very, very soon. Not quite sure where I will be next. It's going to be a random choice before we go back to Alton Towers for Oktoberfest in the middle of September. But that's been it. I want to thank you so much for watching, and as always, happy riding, everybody. I'll see you in the next vlog.